Some combinations. This is Larry Perkins, who's decided to go one out and ignore the current model Commodore and completely rebuild a 1993 version Commodore, the car in which, in fact, he won the race here, well, not the same car, but the same model car that he won the race here in 93. And he and his partner, Russell Ingall, of course, came from a lap down to win the race last year. So you can't knock his record, you cannot knock his judgment.
And you certainly can't knock Larry Perkins' engineering ability at Bathurst. He's done other things in the past where people thought, maybe that won't come off, but he's proved them wrong. And this really is quite a radical step. Just to explain to people at home, the only reason he's gone to the older car is recent technical regulation changes to the latest model Commodore have reduced the level of front-end grip. So going to the older car, he thinks it'll make the tyres more durable and therefore a better race package over the 1,000 kilometres.
Now, the idea behind the change to the front end on the current Commodore was theoretically to slow it down half a second a lap to give greater parity for the Falcons. Doesn't seem to have happened that way.
The only effect it's had is to slow anyone who's not running Bridgestone tyres down more than a second a lap. And the intention of the change was to slow down Holden Racing Team, and that hasn't had any effect on them at all.
And I should have pointed out too that that 93 Bathurst victory for Larry Perkins was done in partnership with the late Greg Hansford, and Larry, of course, his victory last year, another momentous one. And Larry Perkins behind the wheel of the Castrol Commodore. Great to be back here again.
Yeah, thanks very much, Gary. Yeah, it is great, always great to come back to Bathurst. I've just done my quickest practice lap so far of the week. It's not putting me on pole, but it's certainly moved me up, and I feel pretty good.
Now listen, Larry, I just said you've decided to go one out and rebuild a version of an earlier Commodore. You think that's going to pay dividends for you?
Oh, I really don't know, but I'll know by the end of Sunday, but I'm sure it's going to look after my tyres better, and that was the whole idea of it.
You turned in a miraculous performance here last year, Larry. You came from a lap down to win the race, because you can't bank on that kind of thing happening every year.
No, that's very true, and I don't ever want to have to do it as hard as that again, I can tell you. But yeah, let's be honest, we're not on the pace at the moment to run from the front, so we're going to need everything else going for us, and consistency is going to be one of that.
Larry, Mark Osler, I was thinking back to a few races ago when it was raining. Would you be looking forward to wet conditions on Sunday? Larry,
can you hear Barry?
Yeah, Larry, would you look forward to wet conditions on Sunday if that was to come to pass? No, we've lost Larry there.
I'm back again, Gary.
You're back?
Yeah.
Okay, I was going to ask you, or Mark Osler was asking you, Larry, about weather conditions and whether you'd prefer to see it perhaps wet on Sunday.
Oh, look, I hope it pours with rain the whole week, the whole Sunday. My car's superb in the wet, my Dunlop's absolutely superb, and some of the finer points of slick tyres aren't going to come into it, so here's hoping for a wet one.
Okay, Larry, we'll leave it there. Thank